We know that Galileo was an amazing experimentalist, so let's go back to Pisa and repeat his experiment.
The Leaning Tower of Pisa, and we're going to carry out one of Galileo's famous motion experiments. So we've already bought the equipment, we set up the experiment, now all that's left to do is to carry it out. What I'm going to be doing is rolling this hollow cylinder down this inclined plane. I've divided this plane into four sections, equally spaced, and I'm going to be timing how long it takes the cylinder to roll through each section. So that will require four separate measurements. Instead of dripping water to measure time, I'm going to be using a piece of equipment Galileo didn't have access to. An app on my cell phone. We've got our data. Now we'll have to repeat this experiment several times so that we can ensure accuracy. Then we can analyze. Now you're going to do the experiment yourself. To do this experiment, you're going to need the proper equipment. So first you're going to need something flat, and that could be a piece of wood, like you just saw me use, or it could even be something as simple as a book. You're also going to need a measuring device. This could be a meter stick, or a tape measure, or anything else that measures distance. You'll need something to roll, and it should be either spherical or cylindrical. And you'll need a timing device, something that measures in seconds. And you can download these or find one on the internet very easily. Finally, you'll need something to prop your flat object up. This could just be a book that you stick underneath your flat object, or maybe a piece of wood. Doesn't matter. Just the purpose is to make this into an incline. To actually do this experiment, first you're going to need to measure four equally spaced intervals on your flat object. And actually, it doesn't matter what units you use. These could be 1 meter or it could be 2 centimeters. As long as you're consistent, as long as the spacing is the same each time. Then you're going to start taking time measurements. So for each of these four distances, you'll want to time how long it takes the ball to roll from the starting point to the end point. And actually, it's not enough to do this just once for each distance. You'll want to repeat each measurement multiple times. How many is up to you. I would suggest 4 or 5. What you'll then enter into this data table is your average time and the average deviation of those time measurements. You'll enter those numbers here, since you now know how to compute averages and average deviations. And then later in the class, we'll do some data analysis with the class data on these distance measurements. Note one thing. This experiment is done slightly differently than Galileo did it. We're not letting the ball roll for a fixed period of time and then measuring the distance. We're letting the ball roll for a fixed distance, up to 1 or up to 2, and then measuring the time. But this is an equally good way to do this experiment. Good luck.